Hello everyone, today we are going to be speaking about the most important events that happened on 10th of January throughout the year. Let's get started. Elvis Presley made his first recordings for RCA Records in Nashville. Heartbreak Hotel was one of the songs recorded during this session. In 1964, the first US Beatles album introducing the Beatles was released on VJ Records. The album cover showed John, Paul and George with their now famous mop top haircuts, but Ringo had yet to convert. In 1964, the Rolling Stones recorded Not Fade Away at Olympic Studios. The song, which was first recorded by Buddy Holly and his band The Crickets, became the Stones' first US single. In 1953, Joe Stafford was at number one on the UK singles chart with You Belong to Me. She was the first female to have a number one on the UK singles chart. In 1976, CW MC Cole went to number one on the US singles chart with Convoy. It made number two in the UK. He was in fact an advertising agent whose real name was Bill Frees. In 1981, just 1 year after his death, John Lennon, Imagine, started a 4-week run at number one on the UK singles chart. This week, in the top five, he also had two more songs, Happy Christmas, What Is Over, and Just Like Starting Over. But Imagine was voted by the viewers of BBC TV as the best lyrics of all time in a poll broadcast in October 1999. In 1984, Cyndi Lauper became the first female recording artist since Bobby Gentry in 1967 to be nominated for the 5 Grammy Awards. In 2003, a haul of 500 Beatles tapes known as the Get Back Session stolen in the 1970s were found after the UK police cracked a major bootleg operation in London and Amsterdam. 5 men were arrested. Also in 2003, Bee Gees' Maurice Gibb was fighting for his life after a heart attack following major stomach surgery. The 53-year-old singer had been rushed to hospital after collapsing at his Florida home. Here we have the last one from music and the very funny one. In 2006, an Australian woman appeared in court charged with repeatedly stabbing her parent with a pair of scissors in the back, just because he played Elvis Presley's song Burning Love over and over again. In 1946, the first General Assembly of the United States opened. 51 nations were represented on that day. In 1929, the first adventure of Tintin comic book is published. In 1920, the Treaty of Versailles takes effect. In 1863, London Underground opens. In 1912, the world's first flying boat airplane, designed by Glenn Curtiss, makes its maiden flight at Hampton's Port. In Washington in 1918, the House of Representatives passes legislation for women's suffrage. In 1923, the United States withdraws its last troops from Germany. And in 1940, German planes attack 12 ships off the British coast, sinking 3 ships and killing 35 people. Also about Germany, in 1941, the Soviets and Germany agree on the East European borders and the exchange of industrial equipment. In 1984, the United States and the Vatican established full diplomatic relations for the first time in 117 years. Okay, first of all, this picture scares the shit out of me. But it's in 97... I can't even say it. In 1927, Fritz Lang's silent film Metropolis premieres in Berlin. I don't know who watched this movie, I swear, it scares me just seeing the picture. In 1928, just 1 year after the Metropolis film, George Gershwin, Sigmund Rosenberg and P.G. Woodhouse musical Rosalie premieres in New York. In 1932, Pete the Tramp cartoon strips by C.D. Russell debuts. And in 1949, first Jewish family show, Goldbergs, premieres on CBS. And now, here we have some important persons that were born on 10th of January. Ronnie Hawkins, Scott McKenzie, Rod Stewart, Joey Santiago, Chris Smith, Cesar Cielo, Brian Cowen, Pat Benatar, George Foreman. But also we have some unfortunate deaths on 10th of January, like David Bowie, Howlin' Wolf, Coco Chanel, Samuel Colt and Carl Linnaeus. Well, that will be it for today's video, guys. If you liked it, please subscribe to the channel, and I'm gonna post it every single day until I'm gonna finish every day. So it's gonna take 365 days to complete this series. So if you liked it, subscribe, like I said, like the video, and I'm gonna see you in the next one.